Well, my stepdad took myself and my brother over there when we were just kids, and he wanted to watch a race, and we saw it. And we saw these kids selling peanuts and popcorn, and so we asked him if we could go back over there the next week and do that. So he carried us over there and let us out. He didn't go to the races, and I don't forget if we jumped a fence or just walked in with some people, but we ended up getting a job selling. You had to start out with popcorn, which was a great old big boxes, and you'd make a penny a box, and which was good money. We may leave there with a dollar or a dollar and a half or whatever it may be, but you know, when the races start, nobody would buy anything. We're watching, so you sat down during the race and you watched the race, and I just loved the sport. I love watching the drivers, and I loved their lifestyle. So it was that's what drew me to racing. Well, that's one reason we wanted to always go early, was to be able to go down there and hang out in the pits with the drivers, and just hang around and watch them and watch their lifestyle. Back in the old days, it was moonshining and partying and having a good old time, and then going out and racing, and that's what they did. They, all of them, not all of them, but a lot of them were good hard racers, but they were good hard partiers as well. Oh, it's, you know, Curtis Turner and Bobby Myers, Billy Myers, it was so many of those guys, Floyd Goins. I can go on and on about a lot of the old names, Carl Burris, people you've never heard of. I think after the second, third year of doing that, maybe when I was 10 years old or something, or maybe even 11, I knew then I wanted to be a race driver. And the more I hung around those guys and the more I watched them and watched the racing, I knew at that point I wanted to be, that's what I wanted to do, is drive a race car someday. Once I got old enough and got my driver's license at 16, and I knew I wanted to race, and I was working at a hosier mill called Adams Millist over in Kernersville. And I knew I wanted to race, and I was looking. Bowman Gray Stadium had a division called the $99 claiming division, and you could go buy a car for $99, which I didn't have, or you could build one. And we bought an old 47 Plymouth from a guy that worked right there at Adams Millis. It was an old taxi cab and turned it into a race car. Yeah, it was Jerry Cooper. We bought this old Plymouth and we flipped a coin and he won it. He drove the first week, I drove the second. After I drove a race in it, I knew I wanted to race every week. So we went out and borrowed enough money, come up and bought an old 54 Plymouth. So we were a two-car team after two or three races there. It was really neat just to be on the same track that they were in, the historical part of Bowman Gray Stadium at the time. And to be able to race there was quite exciting the very first time. I remember going out there for the first race and pulling out there, and you're just over there, you beat and banged and fought and whatever it took. You know, I always had some pretty big boys around me when I was racing. And you go out there and you beat and bang and race as hard as you can. And I just loved it. The first year we just raced at Bowman Gray Stadium. After that, we'd go to Tar Heel Speedway and some of the little local tracks around here and race if they had a similar division. I was just a bunch of friends. We'd get together and build the old race car up. And it was nothing but a bunch of guys that loved what they was doing. It gave us a chance to go party and have fun and have a lot of fun after the race.